HP 840 EliteBook is business class of laptops which will offer nice looking design, good processor which will easily handle all office tasks and long battery life for this type of device. This video will review some of the good and not so good features of this notebook. Note that HP 840 has no DVI port, so if you want to use external monitor with DVI connector, you will need display port to DVI adapter. One of the best features of this laptop is battery life. HP CMO3XL 3 cell battery offers in practice 5 to 7 hours of work with Wi-Fi on, depending on how intensive the device is used in this period of time. Integrated web camera has a good 720p picture and integrated mic sound quality is more than enough for a conference or Skype calls. The keyboard has adjustable background lights and the keys on the keyboard are probably the best laptop keys I ever tried. Just the right amount of pressure is needed, the response from the keys is very good, so there is a little doubt was your input successfully received or not. Touchpad is sensitive and responds well even on slight touch. Top and bottom input buttons are easy to reach and can be used as preferred by user. Screen is not a full HD, actually it is 1600x900 resolution and brightness and viewing angles are not very good. Hardware specifications of this laptop. Intel i5-5300U 4-core processor. 8GB of RAM in single slot, so no dual channel advantages unless additional memory is purchased and installed. Integrated Intel 5500 graphic card, Samsung SSD drive with capacity of 256 GB, 4G modem which you can use to connect to internet via SIM card, overall performance of the system when it comes to the office work is very good. Laptop works without any issues or staggering. Office applications are starting fast, and 8 GB of RAM is more than enough to support multiple applications running at the same time without any issues. When it comes to multimedia, HP 840 G2 is borderline capable to play even 4K videos without staggering. We detected some small frame skipping when 4K video is played, but in general, even though it was not completely smooth experience, it was possible to view 4K video. In next minutes, I will perform some detailed performance test. You can skip to the end of the video for final conclusions. CPU Z benchmark test shows that i5-5300U has a good single-thread performances, but multi-threading is not even close to be good as on some desktop rivals. Next tests performed are done in PassMark Performance Test Tool. CPU mark is pretty good considering that this CPU is made for mobile devices with power saving in mind. Memory mark is excellent, and it would be even better if second slot is installed and dual channel is activated. SSD offers good performance, and even though in this test it has average results, in practice I'm very happy with how fast this SSD performs. It takes just above 1 minute to start Windows 7 and load first applications. While 2D graphic results are surprisingly good, it needs to be pointed that this laptop has integrated Intel 5500 graphic chip and it is not made with gaming in mind. This is obvious as well from 3D performance test results. If you plan to use this laptop for gaming, integrated Intel graphic card is not a good choice and you should select some of the models with better Nvidia or AMD graphic cards. Of course, you will be able to play some older 3D releases of the games, but newer games will probably be too much for HP 840G2. Last but not the least, beer spill test. What happens if you accidentally spill some beer on this laptop? Thanks for watching. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, please like this video and subscribe. It costs nothing to you and it means a lot for me and this channel. See you in the next video.